Oh, WWE, you dirty damn dogs. You evil sons of bitches. Oh, man. Just when I think they can't outdo themselves, just when I think the WWE can't top themselves, they find a way to just completely exceed my expectations and do exactly what even I think is impossible for them. I did a recent video talking about why Dean Ambrose versus Seth Rollins, not John Cena versus Randy Orton, should be the main event match of Hell in a Cell 2014. At a time where the WWE desperately needs to create new stars, you know, why go with a match we've seen hundreds of times when you can sit there and have a new feud with fresher, younger talents actually main event the show? At a time, again, where you need to create new stars, you could have two new stars really be launched by having them be the spotlighted attraction, the real featured match at Hell in a Cell 2014. Their storyline has been better. The performances of the two characters have been better. The styles of both of these guys, both individually and collectively together, makes for a more entertaining Hell in a Cell match, knowing that the people would actually want to see this close out the show. I mean, there's all these, you know, uno, dos, tres, ding-dong, dum-dick, says fucking reasons to do it. So, of course, the WWE said, oh, no, 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 no. We are going to give you, the fans, an attitude adjustment. See, that's why Cena's finisher is called the Attitude Adjustment. It's not for the opponents. It's for the fans. It's meant to try and adjust your attitude towards what the WWE does and all their stupid crap. It's bad enough that they're going to Orton versus Cena for the umpteenth dozen millionth fucking time. But you had to know deep down inside that no matter how much logic dictated that Ambrose versus Rollins needed to be, deserved to be, and should be the main event of Hell in a Cell 2014, WWE was going to find a way to say, we're going to do more of the same old lousy shit. You know, there's not a better match stipulation in terms of name that I could think of to describe John Cena versus Randy Orton at a WWE pay-per-view than Hell in a Cell. Because watching these two guys wrestle at a pay-per-view is hell. And it's going to be in a steel cell. Ta-da! Hell in a Cell. It's perfect. And now the WWE has doubled down. The WWE has decided to give you that attitude adjustment. The WWE has decided to give you that RKO'd out of nowhere by saying the winner of Randy Orton versus John Cena gets a future title shot against Brock Lesnar whenever the fuck the WWE World Heavyweight Champion returns. Oh, you sick, sadistic fucks. It's like the WWE gets off on pissing people off. I kind of admire that sometimes, while it pisses me off at the same time. It's like the WWE intentionally sits there and says, look at all these great, awesome things that we can do. Let's just fucking piss the people off and do what we want. You know, if the WWE devoted half of the time and energy and effort and investment of so many things, capital, resources, into doing new creative things as they do into pissing people off and doing the same old fucking shit, this company would be in a whole lot of better position than they are right now. Randy Orton versus John Cena, now you can book it. This fucking main event in Hell in a Cell 2014. What makes this so bad is you've got a match between Dean Ambrose and Seth Rollins that's either going to mid-card or perhaps even be the curtain jerker. And everybody knows, goddamn good and well going into it, that this is going to be the match that steals the night. This is going to be the match that steals the show for so many different reasons. It's not even going to end the show. So half or most, if not all the rest of the damn show is going to have to try and foul. And you're going to sit there and trot out John Cena versus Randy Orton in your main event, knowing damn good and well that no matter where you have that fucking match, it's mostly going to be crickets. Both sides are going to be booed. And the crowd is going to violently turn on the match almost instantaneously. And the WWE says, that's good for business. Makes it even worse, though. Is there are people that sit there and think that this means that they're going to get Orton versus Lesnar for the title and like the Royal Rumble? Who else are you going to send Orton at? What are you going to do? Okay, let's play along. Let's just say, in your drunken fantasy world, that this is intended to have Orton go against. I can't even say it with a straight face. Orton versus Jimmy Johns. The freaking Rumble. So, you're going to take the guy that is heel, being aligned with the authority, who you're trying to turn face, and match him up against the WWE World Heavyweight Champion that hasn't appeared and wrestled for fucking months, that people now like, you know, even though the WWE didn't intend it to be that way, because he kicked the shit out of John Cena at SummerSlam to win the title in the first place. The same guy he ended the Undertaker's WrestleMania streak at WrestleMania 30. Better way to stop. Just put your stamp on a middling, sorry-ass babyface turn for Randy Orton than to send him up against Brock Lesnar, your top babyface. And I said that right, people. Your top babyface in WWE. You know this is an excuse. You know damn good and well, unless they call last second audible, you know damn good and well, this is nothing more than an excuse to sit there and send Randy Orton at Seth Rollins, and they could do the face turn that way, so that way they could give you John Cena versus Brock Lesnar at the Royal Rumble for the WWE World Heavyweight Championship. You really think, with the way shit ended at Night of Champions, that Cena's not going to get his? You really think, when it comes to Night of Champions, that Cena's not going to get another match against him? You really think that the WWE isn't potentially situating themselves with a backup plan to potentially put that belt back on John Cena heading into WrestleMania season? You're fucking fooling yourself. You're going to sit there and do a John Cena-Seth Rollins feud. Maybe you're right. Oh, God, I can only imagine. Do you really want any part of John Cena going at Seth Rollins? No, you don't. At least you know if Orton goes at Rollins, there's a chance that Rollins won't get totally buried and decimated by Randall Keith Orton. Where you know damn good and well, if a Seth Rollins gets sent in to John Cena, it's going to mean curtains for Seth Rollins as a big-time guy. See, you get the fucking point. God bless the WWE. It's like Vince McMahon has one remaining mission statement in his senile, sorry, fucking rich-ass life. Just sit there and piss off as many people as he can before he goes to the fucking grave. Dean Ambrose versus Seth Rollins. Multitude of reasons to fucking main event it. So we'll give the people what they really want. That's John Cena versus Randy Orton in the main event. And we'll throw in a title match stipulation to a winner gets a title shot against Lesnar in a future pay-per-view. Couldn't you sit there and give Ambrose and Rollins that? At least make it about the Money in the Bank briefcase? Maybe put that at stake? Ah, oh, fuck it. Who cares at this point? This is why sometimes it's so hard to sit there and still be a fan of the WWE and professional wrestling in general. Because you just see this glaringly obvious, stupid stuff. These dumb dick decisions. And you want to sit there and ask a big corporation like the WWE, what possible redeeming qualities can there be to this? What possibly could be your thought process or mindset that sits there and justifies to you having Orton versus Cena being the main event of Hell in a Cell over Dean Ambrose versus Seth Rollins? The only thing that it is more funny than is sad. It's very sad. It's so sad. It makes me laugh. Oh, I can't wait till Hell in a Cell Sunday. People are going to boo that fucking Cena Orton match out of the fucking building, especially when Cena wins. Because even if you sit there and say, well, Orton's going to win, when's Orton going to fucking beat Cena clean? And what, are they going to have Rollins interfere with Cena? It wouldn't even make any sense at this point. If anything, Rollins would interfere with Orton. Oh, God. Why can't they sit there and focus on trying to put on a creative, compelling program? Why put so much effort into trying intentionally to screw shit up? Why put so much energy and emphasis on trying to sit there and do this dumb shit that has no possible merit or justification for it happening? They get off on pissing off the fans. Only the WWE and only professional wrestling fans like all of us would be stupid enough to put up with it and say, thank you, sir. May I have another?